camera crew and challenge him to take me to the shitty affiliate. Look, I don't think this is dire, and I don't think that, I don't know how serious the threat is, but what we're doing, our thing, is so important to me that any threat is serious. I owe it to my affiliates to look them in the eyes and tell them what I'm thinking and where my head's at and what pisses me off and what doesn't, you know? That's something you get on a plane and go do, you know? Hi. I got on a plane with my staff to come talk to you. I don't want to make too big a deal of the purpose. I don't think this icy reps thing, is that what you call it? Yeah, I don't think it's an existential threat. I don't think it is. But it's kind of the thought that counts. I have a problem with extortion, it turns out. Right? But we got a guy here that told the world that we'd killed people in the States. And you probably know that's patently false. This turd has partners in the American College of Sports Medicine and the National Strength and Conditioning Association. And they too have lied about injuries. We're suing them too. We're suing Richard Beddy, in case you don't know. And you understand that in our industry, that falsely accusing a training program of deaths is like accusing a daycare center of pedophilia. You understand that? And that's done very deliberately. They know exactly the impact, they know exactly the harm, and it was done deliberately. He knew it to be a lie. There's a protection racket. You know that term? You ever heard that before? Protection racket? It might be an Americanism. But it goes like this. The guys come around and tell you about the nice glass you have out front, and for a fee, they're gonna protect it. Make sure that your windows don't get broken. Well, you go, I don't need that. My windows aren't gonna get broken. Get out of here. And then that night, what happens? Your windows get broken. Then they come back again. We told you, we tried to help you with that. It's a common extortion. This guy's got a variant of it. I don't know if you can call this the Kiwi version or what. You probably don't want your names on it. But what he did was he told the press that we were killing people, then came to us and said, see this lousy press you're getting? We can fix that at reps. Which is really ballsy to bust my windows, then come in and offer to protect me from window breakers. Thank you and good afternoon. It's an incredible honor to be here. I want to share with you, I don't have any plans. I don't have any ambition for my legacy, for my staff's legacy. Even my children, my staff's children, all of our futures, they're tied to your work, to what you do. And I can't imagine being held in better hands. The world's never seen anything like this. And I'm here to tell you that it is dangerous, but it's dangerous to the status quo. Not to the people you're working with, but to the Richard Beddies of the world, to the William Kramers of the world, to the IC reps, icky reps, what is it? IC reps. The NSCA, the ACSM. And their sponsors. Yeah. Where do you think this is going? The figure he wanted was 400 New Zealand dollars per trainer, which is about $30 million if you spread that around the world. Remember, it's an international consortium or confederation of registrars of exercise professionals. We got 100,000 trainers around the world. I know how to multiply that times $300 US. It's a lot of money. It's a heck of a motive. It's a heck of a motive. I've even gone here. What, look, would I yield to oversight? Sure, if you had the moral authority, the background, the experience, the intelligence. If I were to learn to fly my plane, I would let my pilot, who is a flight instructor, teach me. And he could oversee me and supervise and give inputs. But how about me overseeing him? I don't know anything about it. Do you realize that the people that want to regulate you, control you, don't even know what you do? I mean, they can describe it, they can point it out, they can talk about it, but they don't know the movements. We'd have to teach Dick Beddie how to squat. Yeah. And then we'd have to teach him how to teach people how to squat. And then years later, he could maybe talk about joining your ranks and being a peer. I looked at the signatories to this thing, and it looks like a who's who of the old way of doing things. It looks like the people that we've left behind. These are the people that, how many of you have worked in a Globo gym before? Hands up high, let me see, we'd be proud. You know what's going on in there? Is there anyone back in that environment that's got any logical, moral, intellectual, or other experiential authority to supervise what you're doing? It's absolutely absurd. I wouldn't sign if he paid me $30 million. Do you understand that? I don't want to be associated with them. I don't want my name, our good work, your efforts, your name, your business associated with these people. They have blood on their hands. They are corrupt. Their stewardship of our industry has been an unmitigated first-class disaster. I blame them for the diet that kills. I blame them for the ineffective exercise. Have they spoken out against the high-carb, low-fat diet? No, they promote it to this very day. It's absurd. It's absurd. Now, you're doing something that needs to be left alone. It needs to be supported. It needs to be promoted. You're doing the right things for the right people for the right reasons. And the least I can do is defend you at every opportunity I have with everything I've got. And I will do whatever it takes to keep you free, to keep you safe, to keep your reputations just what they deserve to be. I want you to fight. I think you should be pissed. I think you should be indignant. And I'm willing to fund, fuel, support, and incite any kind of response you want to get. We're doing something that, you know, when little kids dream of getting to do the things that we do someday, getting to have the impact on their fellow human beings that we have. And I want to thank you for being at the heart of all of that. You really are. You are the heart. All right. Good night.